Back joining us as always is Bryan Waldman from the Sinas Dramis Law Firm. Americans have only a few mandatory civic duties, and serving as a juror is one of them. Most people tend to dread jury duty for a variety of reasons. So Bryan, why do we have mandatory jury service?
Well, Siobhan, the U.S. Constitution guarantees us the right to have both our civil and criminal disputes resolved by a jury of our peers. And it's a foundation of our democratic society. We all benefit from that constitutional right. And if it's going to work, all of us have to participate in it. In my opinion, it really shouldn't be viewed as a burden. It really isn't what I believe to be one of the most patriotic things you can do as an American, is serve on a jury.
How does someone get called for jury service?
Well, what happens is it's a little different in the state and federal system. In the state court system, the Michigan Secretary of State once a year assembles a list of people who are eligible to be jurors. And then the courts take that information. They send out questionnaires to check some things. Mm-hmm. People are required to return those questionnaires promptly, and from those responses, lists are made to randomly select people to come in for jury duty.
Okay, what are the requirements to be eligible to serve on a jury?
To be eligible to serve as a juror, a person has to be a citizen of the United States, 18 years or older, mm-hmm. a resident of the circuit or district court where they're being called to perform jury service, mm-hmm. They have to be able to communicate in English. They have to be physically and mentally capable of performing jury service. Mm-hmm. And it's a requirement that they not be convicted of a felony prior to their service.
Okay, what happens if someone doesn't show up for jury duty?
That's a serious problem. So they actually get a summons. A person will get a summons requiring them by court order to appear. Mm-hmm. And if they don't, they can be held in contempt of court, and there can be penalties, including fines and actual jail time.
Are there any reasons a person can be excused from jury duty?
There are. If a person has already served or done their jury service within the last year, they should be excused from doing it again. Mm-hmm. If a person is over the age of 70 or 70 or older, they have the right to opt out of jury service.
Okay.
And the last one is nursing mothers can also opt out of jury service.
Oh, that's good to know.
Makes sense.
Yeah. All right, Bryan, thank you. Important information. I do have more questions for you about jury service, but we're out of time for tonight, so we're going to get to those questions next week. Stay tuned for that. Bryan, as always, thanks for giving us the Legal Edge.
Thank you.
Joining us, as always, is Bryan Waldman from the Sinas Dramis Law Firm. So last week we talked about jury service, specifically how people are picked for it. Today we're going to focus on what happens inside the courtroom. So Bryan, what should people expect if they get that far into the process?
Sure. If jurors are actually brought into the courtroom, they're brought with a large group of people. They'll take an oath, and then randomly, certain jurors will be called to actually sit in the jury box.
Okay. So, but just because their name is drawn and because they're sitting in the jury box does not necessarily mean that they are going to end up on a jury, because there are some questions from not only the judge but lawyers as well, right?
Right. The judge and lawyers will ask questions, and that process is called voir dire. And the purpose of voir dire is to ensure that there's a fair and impartial jury deciding the case. So the judge, the lawyers are asked questions to determine if potential jurors know witnesses, know the parties, or if there's something in their background that just makes it so that they can't be fair in that particular case.
So what if it is determined that someone is biased or they can't be fair in the case?
Well, one of two things will happen. A lawyer can move and ask that the judge make a decision that juror be moved for what's known as cause or a for-cause challenge. Mm-hmm. And sometimes the judge will just do that on his or her own initiative, remove the juror because they just can't be fair.
And can lawyers do that as well, just remove that person if they?
Well, lawyers have the ability to again, request that the judge make the decision, but they're also given a number of what's called peremptory challenges, which are essentially certain dismissal of jurors for no reason. The lawyer can just say, thank you, juror number six, we'd like you to be replaced.
Oh, just like that?
Absolutely.
Okay. Are there any limitations to a lawyer's challenges?
There are. The lawyer can bring as many challenges for cause as he or she wants, but the peremptory challenges are limited in number based on the type of case. And additionally, under a case called Batson versus Kentucky, it's forbidden for a lawyer to exclude a juror solely based on race, ethnicity, or gender.
Okay.
And it's a very difficult thing to prove, but it does happen, and courts have actually ordered new trials because lawyers have violated that rule.
Well, all right, Bryan, thank you. And you can catch part one of this segment on our website, WLNS.com, and we'll also post this one as well. Bryan, thank you so much, as always, for giving us the Legal Edge.
Thank you, Siobhan.